in Kansas and all across America.
From Lawrence, Kansas, this is Jeremy, Independent Line.
Yes, good morning.
Good morning, Jeremy.
I think it's good morning, Representative. I think it's time for the American people to understand that the people and nation of Iran are our potential natural ally if we were to negotiate and engage with them in an enlightened, firm, and honest manner. And really, in terms of that region, the only state that has threatened the use of nuclear weapons and that has recognized nuclear weapons by everybody who's willing to be honest is Israel. And as a Jewish American, I can see that what's going on here is that, you know, for at least like probably 15 years, it's every half year, the Israeli deep state is claiming that Iran is 6 months away from a nuclear weapon. This is terrorism to some extent, to threaten the American people psychologically with a non-existent existential threat. Even Ahmadinejad, which is claimed in the largely Zionist-controlled American media to have said that he was going to wipe the Israel off the map, it was a dishonest representation of what he said. He said that there would be a change in the Zionist regime, that it would be change in history. And so I think that it's time for the American people to understand that the threats to our Constitution are not halfway around the world. They're much closer to the home. In Kansas, for example, we have like Representative Pompeo and Senator Pat Roberts who support the evisceration of the Fourth Amendment to the Constitution in terms of their support for NSA treason. Pat Roberts specifically was partially responsible for making the Snowden leaks necessary by not allowing NSA whistleblower Russell Tice
Jeremy,
to constitutionally
finish up. Go ahead and finish only because I want to let the representative comment on what you said.
Okay.
Representative.
Jeremy, thanks for coming on the show. Is a lot in there? Let me take two points. First, I find it offensive that you talk about the Zionist control media. I don't think Pedro would tell you that he is controlled by the Zionist, a member of the media. I find that a deeply troubling statement. Your initial remarks, I actually agree with. You talked about the Iranian people and the potential for them to be part of a world of peace. I actually think that's possible. I think there are enormous numbers of the ordinary citizenry in Iran who would be prepared to do that. That's one of the mistakes this president made when we had an opportunity to support an upstart group of folks inside of Iran who were prepared to try and overthrow the regime that has threatened to destroy Israel and kill everyone in the great state, and that's us, in Lawrence, Kansas, and in Wichita, Kansas, and all across. The president's policy should have been to express deep support for the Iranian people and deep hostility towards the Iranian regime, which is intent on continuing to expand terror around the world. Had we done that, had we rewarded folks inside of Iran who were prepared to overthrow this regime from inside, not from outside, not imposed upon them by the West or anyone else, we would have developed a much more effective set of policies, and we'd have a much better outcome than we have sitting here on the morning of July 15th.
Fort Lee, New Jersey,